My name is Brenton House, and welcome to API Cybersecurity 101. As you know from previous episodes, there are a few core components to API security that can help shield your APIs against cyber attacks. Today, we're going to talk about two of these: Software AG Web Methods API Gateway and the API security products provided by Salt Security. Stay tuned to find out more. Welcome to a special episode of API Cybersecurity 101. Today we have the opportunity to talk to Salt Security about their products and the partnership between Software AG and Salt Security to address the rapidly growing issue of API security. On the show today, we have Michelle McLean. Michelle is the Vice President of Marketing at Salt Security. She has more than 20 years experience in marketing and is responsible for overseeing all of the company's marketing strategy and initiatives. Thank you for joining us on the show today, Michelle.
Brenton, it's great to be with you and excited to be talking about this partnership with Software AG.
So APIs have been around for a long time, but the creation and adoption of APIs is growing exponentially. What are you or your customers seeing that's making API security an important issue today?
Yeah, it's really an interesting topic because we can get a little bit complacent about technology that's been around for a while, but APIs are being used in really different ways. And there's a few internal factors and external factors, I think, driving that. So, you know, from the business perspective, APIs are fueling tremendous innovation. We're using more of them than ever. They're more capable than ever. They're more functional because essentially, if you say you're building an app today, you're using APIs. You're doing digital transformation, you're using APIs. Cloud migration, cloud native development, it's all hinged on APIs. So they're a lot more robust and they're sharing a lot more valuable, sensitive data. It's what they're designed to do. Like that enables a lot of business functionality. The challenge is at the same time, there's been this external factor of bad actors understanding this development and recognizing, APIs are pretty much all about sharing crown jewels. So if I go after APIs, my chance of a good payout is pretty high. And I think once again, there's a couple of factors at play in that. One, they realize the whole reason you write APIs is to share valuable data and services. So they know it's going to be lucrative. And two, whether or not they intentionally know this, the reality is that existing defenses, existing security approaches, existing API management platforms, through no fault of their own, they're not built for understanding API attacks today. They're built for a different purpose. And we'll get into more of that color a little bit later. But, you know, you simultaneously have a really attractive target and poor defenses. So it just makes APIs fertile ground for bad actors. And you see it all the time. I mean, this will date the conversation a little bit, but just this weekend, news came out about an API vulnerability in Coinbase. So I could go in and initiate a transaction, and I could say that the from account for a given crypto transaction was an account that I have no access to. Like, there was no authorization associated with my initiating an API call to do a funds transfer. That's pretty alarming, right? In the case of Coinbase, that could have been, we go out of business. You know, not all API vulnerabilities are that severe, but that one's up there. But Coinbase is by no means alone. These things happen all the time. And there's, you know, authentication challenges, authorization challenges, manipulation. And, you know, luckily this was a white hat hacker and not a bad actor who found this vulnerability and did responsible disclosure. But companies all over the place are susceptible to these kinds of challenges.
Threats like these are scary because they're real. So tell us a little more about Salt Security and the products that you provide to protect APIs.
Sure. So we took a different approach that really wanted to dig in on how is it that API attacks happen and what's going on in the stack that we can complement. So companies release APIs through API management platforms like Software AGs, through integrator systems, and many of these APIs will reside in those systems, but often you have APIs released outside of those systems as well. So your first big challenge in the area of APIs is just knowing your landscape, what's out there. So Salt comes in, plugs into the environment in a number of ways, including our integration with Software AG, and captures the full inventory of APIs, captures both the list of APIs and which of these APIs expose sensitive data and where. So, you know, you can't control what you can't see. So first off, automated continuous discovery. It's the foundation for everything that you do in API security. The second area of focus is really in understanding attackers and detecting that an attack is happening. APIs are super interesting because your APIs are going to be different to my APIs. And so if I'm a bad actor targeting your APIs, I first have to learn what they do. That takes a lot of reconnaissance. That takes a lot of trial and error. If I do this, what'll happen? If I do this, what'll happen? And understanding that an attack is unfolding requires really rich context. You have to know what normal is for all your users, for all your APIs over time, to be able to detect that somebody's playing some games here, somebody's manipulating things, they're calling things out of order, or they're manipulating a user ID and a subsequent API call, like what happened with the Coinbase vulnerability. That takes context over time. You have to be able to correlate activity. API attacks unfold over days, weeks, months. So you really need to stitch together a lot of data over time. So Salt brings that ability to pinpoint an attacker, correlate all that activity, stitch that together into a single attacker timeline. So you're not getting hundreds of alerts, even though they did hundreds of manipulations, and then have a mechanism for blocking that attacker. So we, for instance, do not sit in line. It is a very conscious choice. We do not want to affect the behavior of the apps running these API calls. But then we need a system like Software AG to take action against that attacker. And so part of what our integration does is not just enable that discovery, but also give us an enforcement mechanism for issuing a call to block an attacker. So the second main area of focus is that attack detection and prevention by partnering with the inline devices that are already in the customer's environment. And the third area has everything to do with security posture overall. How do we just write better, more secure APIs? And there's two dimensions to that in the Salt platform. The first is what we're able to do pre-prod. So pre-prod, before the API has even been released, upload your Swagger or your OWASP files. We'll look at it, look for areas where you may not have adhered to API security best practices. We don't need any traffic running. We're just doing analysis of your API design and looking for gaps there. The second thing that we can do pre-prod is actually run traffic against it, run test traffic against it, and look for logic flaws, look for gaps in the business flow that somebody could take advantage of. So look for those API vulnerabilities, again, pre-release. And then the third thing that we do is actually incorporate what we learn at runtime and feed that back into the dev cycle to harden APIs over time. So I told you attacks can unfold over days and weeks and months. It could take many, many steps. I'm going to try this. I'm going to try that. They'll have little minor successes on their way toward trying to reach their objective. But those minor successes won't really be a breach. They didn't really succeed, but you can still learn from those. They shouldn't have gotten a 200 okay message. They should have gotten a 400 error message when they tried that manipulation. So we'll take those runtime insights and feed them back into the dev cycle to harden APIs. So discovery, attack prevention, and posture, security posture improvement. That's what the Salt platform does.
Well, it's great hearing about how Salt Security is working to stop attackers and protect APIs everywhere. You mentioned how important it is to discover and know as much as you can, and you also mentioned API gateways. So how does your product work with organizations that are managing their APIs with an API gateway like Software AG WebMethods?
Yeah, So this is one of our most common ways of integrating into our customers' environments. And again, you guys are doing a wealth of capabilities that we don't do, right? You're doing a bunch of stuff around schema standardization and things like that, and management of the APIs more broadly. So it's a really perfect complement. So we plug in with simple integration. It can be a rule. It can be a, you know, tap port on a device. We have lots of ways to come into the environment really inobtrusively and just get a copy of the API traffic. So that's all we're doing, is we're tapping into the web methods platform and just getting a copy of the API traffic. It's still flowing separate from the SALT system. We're not getting in the way. We're not slowing things down, but we get that copy, and that informs that cloud scale big data that we're applying to the problem of understanding the landscape and being able to pinpoint attackers. So we tap into you to get that copy. And then the second way that we integrate with you is that enforcement piece. If we see an attack underway, we can do one of two things. We can send an alert, because often our customers, as much as they love the idea of automated stopping of attackers, they don't always trust it right out of the gate. They want to know that you got it right. And so often they'll say, don't do anything automatic yet. Flag it for me. I'll have a human look at it. We'll decide if it's indeed malicious. And then straight in the SALT platform, you just send a command to the web methods platform to block. And you can block in a number of ways. You can block on IP, although they often are mischievous and they'll change their IP. So you can block on a user ID, an account ID, any other sort of token, if you will, of what this attacker is doing, and block the whole attacker, not each individual attack. So we do that via the integration with web methods as well.
That's a fantastic look at how easily you can integrate with web methods. You mentioned several great features that your product has. So what makes SALT Security Platform different than other API security products on the market today?
Yeah, we have the advantage of having been first to market, and sometimes that can mean somebody will come a little later and sort of leapfrog you. But in this particular case, being first to market is enormously advantageous, because we were built on the next generation of technology around big data. You cannot solve an API security problem without big data. But what we uniquely saw was the scale that you would need. Again, if these attacks, you know, think about the LinkedIn data scraping that unfolded over about 15 months to pull all those millions of records. That means you're seeing activity over a long period of time. So what we understood was not just that you needed big data, but you needed cloud scale big data. You needed to be able to store this information over a long period of time. So one of the things that differentiates us is the richness of the context, because we're running at cloud scale. And, you know, somebody who says, yeah, we take a big data approach and we can shove it into a VM, put it on your prem. How much time are you really getting there? What can they really store? Any individual server is not going to give you a rich enough data set to do an effective job at understanding these really multi-stepped, very sophisticated API attacks. So the first thing that sets us apart is the architecture, cloud scale, big data. The second thing that sets us apart is that time in market. You cannot solve this problem without AI and ML. And those algorithms are only as good as they've been trained. They're only as smart as what they've been exposed to. So time in market and number of customers is totally consequential. You will have very uninformed algorithms when you've only been in market, you know, a year or less, and you only have like five customers. For us, being deployed in thousands of environments over the last 4+ years means that our algorithms have seen the most of any API security platform. It makes them smarter, it makes them more well-tuned. And our customers really talk about the network effect. The fact that we're deployed in a company like Takeda Pharmaceuticals means that when Markel Insurance Company goes to use our platform, they're benefiting from everything that ever happened on the Takeda environment. And we have that cascading across dozens and dozens of companies, big Fortune 500 companies. And the assurity that the next customer is benefiting from all the learning of those previous customers is hugely powerful to them, because they know we've sort of crowdsourced the answer here in a way that you really can't you can't make up for that. There is no substitute for time and there is no substitute for exposure when it comes to making your algorithm smarter. So the architecture that we embarked on from the get-go and the maturity of our algorithms is what sets the SALT solution apart. And we love bake-offs. We love to have customers throw anything they can at our platform and compare us to other platforms, see what we're able to detect versus they're able to detect. And we always win in those bake-offs. So we relish that opportunity.
Well, that's great. API security is so important today, and I love being able to hear about how products like those from SALT Security are attacking cybersecurity issues head on. Well, thank you, Michelle, for joining me today, and I look forward to hearing more from SALT Security in the days to come.
Excellent, Brenton. Thanks for having me on today. Really appreciate it.